your way onto your mat. You're going to turn, face the right side, make your way down onto your back. If it feels okay, we're going to start with the knees into the chest. If you don't like that, you can start with the feet flat down on the ground. Just get comfortable, rock around a little if it feels good. Take some long, slow breaths. Try to let your shoulders relax. Just noticing how you're feeling through the fronts of the hips, through your low back. Taking some time to slow the breath down and seeing how it feels to take those long, deep inhales. So maybe you're a little bit stressed this morning and it feels a little bit tense in the lower parts of the lungs and the air stuck up in the top. Try to really stretch those lungs out as you inhale. And when you exhale, you can exhale out through the mouth if it's more comfortable for you. Just breathing here a few times. Long, deep inhales and exhales. Like to, you can set an intention for your practice, so just anything, any goal, any word, something that you can bring your focus to, send your energy towards. Pull the belly back to center. Bring the knees back up and we'll let them drop over to the other side. Exhale, come back to center, knees towards your chest, grab hold of your left shin, we're going to extend the right leg out nice and long, pull the knee in really tight, see if you can squeeze the glute over on the right leg, letting your hip flexor relax. Bring the ankle outside of the right leg and you're going to slide the foot down towards the opposite ankle so your legs are crossed and slide it back up so the knee is bent. So just taking it a couple times like that. Breathing deeply each time. Times. Try to keep your hips down. See if you can pull the leg towards you a little bit more. Pointing and flexing at the foot. knee, take the foot down. We'll switch over to the other side. So right knee into the chest, give it a tight hug. Lengthen the opposite leg out as long as you can. Really pulling in. Long, deep breaths here. Seeing if you can squeeze the glute on your left leg. And then when it feels good, you're going to do the same thing as we did on the other side. So you're going to take that right ankle outside the left thigh, lengthen down towards the opposite ankle, and back up. Noticing how that feels for your hip. Ceiling. Point and flex the foot a few times, maybe rotate the ankle. Just seeing if you can pull it in a little bit closer. Don't forget to breathe. And then when you're ready, both knees into the chest, hands on the knees, draw some big circles. Taking those knees out and away from each other, and then in the opposite direction when you're ready. And then when it feels good, knees into the chest, give yourself a hug, maybe lifting up off the ground a little. We'll start to rock forward and back. Moving through it a few times. And then finding your way up to seated. Crossing at the ankles, lengthen up tall. Inhale the arms up over the head. Reaching really long. As you exhale, twist over towards the left. Let your shoulders relax back. Opening up. And then we'll inhale back up to center, lengthen as tall as you can. Exhale over to the other side. Inhale all the way back up, change the cross in your legs. We're going to twist over towards the left again. Inhaling back to center, lengthen up. Exhale over towards the right. Inhaling back up, lengthen as long and tall as you can. And then exhale, fold your way down. Chin towards your chest. Move your head around a little. And then when it feels good, make your way over to all fours. I realize now I'm not facing the left side of my mat, I'm facing the right side of my mat, so if you have your mat long with, we're going to the right. When it feels good, start to move through cat and cow a few times, just seeing how it feels. Try to get really bendy in those elbows as you move here. Continuing to breathe, long and deep breaths. And then find your way back to center. Deep inhale, reach up with the left arm, take it as high as you can. As you exhale, thread under, bring your head and shoulder down to the ground, opposite arm can reach. And then gently coming back, we'll take it to the other side. So lifting up with the right arm as tall as you can, as you exhale, thread under, head and shoulder down, extend the opposite arm long. Breathing here. Or just tap your toes out to the sides and then back in a couple of times, internally rotating those hips. If it feels okay, maybe you can sit your hips back a little bit more. And then we're going to come back through center. Take your right leg over the left, slide your way back like you're coming towards that modified pigeon, and then we're going to come back to center and over to the other side. So you're not spending a long time here. We're just getting that little bit of stretch and then moving over to the other side. One more on each side. And then coming back to center, pull the belly in. We're going to bring the right leg back, nice and long. Bring the heel towards the booty, squeeze, and then lengthen back out. So just take it like that a few times, squeezing it in and out, getting warm up through that hamstring. Last time here. And then bring that knee back in, switch over to the other side. So left leg back, pull in through the belly, squeeze in the heel, lengthen out. And then we'll come back through center, tuck your toes, start to slide your hips up and back. Don't straighten your legs all the way, but find downward facing. You can pedal one leg and the other. And when it feels good for you, you're going to take your right leg up as high as you can, bend at the knee, open the hips, try to point the knee up towards the ceiling, and then draw some really big circles. Maybe bring the knee all the way down towards the opposite leg. And then the opposite direction, nice and big. And then find your way back down to center. Come back onto your knees, shift your hips around. And then we'll do the other side. So when it feels good, tucking the toes, slide up to downward facing, keep the knees bent. And we'll send up that left leg, bending the knee, open your hips up. And then we'll draw a big circle. So you're bringing the knee down and all the way around. Maybe taking them in the opposite direction. And then bring that foot down. This time we're going to walk our hands back to our feet. Take the feet a little bit wider than you would normally have them. Grab hold of opposite elbows, and we're going to rock around here. So really rock far. Trying to release in the back. And if it feels okay, see if you can do some big circles. So we're going to come all the way up, open your chest, all the way back down. And then take it in the opposite direction. Really press into those feet. Reaching up at the top, lengthen out as long as you can. And as you exhale, fold back down. Keep the knees bent pretty far. Shift around here. When it feels good, we're going to lengthen up halfway, long through the spine. And then exhale, fold it down. Walk yourself out towards downward facing. We're going to reach up with that right leg again. Lift the leg, squeeze the heel into the booty, same thing as we did on the ground. You're going to lengthen the leg out and squeeze it back in. A couple of times, really press through the heel as you lengthen so your booty gets a nice squeeze. Sink it in a little. Holding here, slow your breath. On your exhale, coming down, holding if it feels okay. We're going to find our way into a twist towards the right. And then see if maybe you want to bring that back foot in. Maybe you can reach for it. Holding here. On your exhale, release, straighten out your front leg, find your way into a half split. Squeeze your inner thighs in towards each other, reach your chest towards your foot. See if you can just sink down a little bit further each time. Notice if you're really rounding in your back and you have your chest far away from your leg, try to lengthen forward instead. And then when it feels good, you're gonna pivot those left toes back behind you, walk yourself over, find your way into gates. You're facing the long edge of the mat. You got that right leg lengthening out. Squeeze your hips forward. As you exhale, we're gonna lean towards our straight leg. You can let that bottom arm release long through that side body. And then we'll lengthen ourselves back up. Bring your hand down to the floor. Adjust your bottom leg as you need to. We're gonna lift the back leg up. So your right leg is lifted, squeeze in your glute, and we're gonna pulse here a little bit. So bring that foot up and down. If you feel it only in the side and not in your booty, bring the heel back a little bit. And then from here, holding if it feels good, we're gonna squeeze the heel in and lengthen out. Time you have it squeezing in. If you can reach for your foot, go for it. Pressing the foot in the hand, opening up that chest, pull in your belly. And then go ahead and release, taking the hands down. I'm now facing the opposite side of my mat, but if you're facing away from me, you can turn yourself around. We're going to hold ourselves in a plank for a moment. And then when it feels good, take your left foot, cross it over your right foot so it's on top. Knees are going to come down, and we're just going to try to sink our hips back a little bit. Maybe you can't come very far. We're just sinking the hips back, wiggle around a little. Don't forget to breathe. Toes and slide back to downward facing dog. Holding here, pedal yourself around, shift one hip and the other. And then when you're ready, we're going to reach up with that left leg, take it up nice and tall, lengthening out, and then squeeze the heel in and reach a couple of times. And then we're going to step the foot all the way forward, finding that kneeling lunge. Back knees down, untuck the toes, lengthen up nice and long, squeezing here. Try to bring the glute into it so you're letting that hip flexor relax. And then just like before, you can maybe just pulse a little bit. Just try to find that stretch. Breathing here. When it feels good, taking your right hand down to the ground, we'll twist to the left. And then if you like, you can bring that back foot in. Maybe you can reach for it, maybe not. Finding that quad stretch. On your next exhale, go ahead and release. Straighten out your front leg, finding half split. Breathing here. Looking good. And when you're ready, we're going to bring our hands to the inside of our foot, pivot that back, that right leg back behind you, reaching up through the hips, finding gate pose. Long through the spine, squeeze everything forward. And then we'll start to lean over to the left. Left hand can come down. Get really long through the side body. And then when it feels good, we're going to come over into that like baby half moon pose. You'll adjust your bottom knee as you need to. Lift up that left leg. Squeeze the heel back a little bit. And then just pulse it. Working in that booty. When you're ready for it, stopping that pulse, squeeze the heel in and out. Notice if your knee starts to come in front of your hip. See if you can keep it behind. One more time here. And then if it feels good, go ahead and grab for the foot, maybe opening up the chest. And then go ahead and release. Turning back to that front side of the mat, finding your way into plank, we're gonna hold it. If your wrists are feeling a little sensitive, maybe you can hold your plank up on your fingertips. And then just like before, except now it's right foot's going to cross over the left foot. Come onto your knees. Start to sink your hips back. Come as far back as you can and kind of wiggle around. When you're ready, unwinding your legs, tucking the toes. Find downward facing dog. Lengthen up nice and long. We're going to do something a little bit weird here, so pay attention. You're going to reach your right leg up, take it nice and high, bend at the knee, open your hips. That part's not the weird part. As you exhale, you're going to bring that right knee under you. See if you can cross your ankle across your left thigh and send those hips high. So you're fighting a figure of four. Breathing here. And then looking forward, we're going to just step that right foot up. Back foot is pointing, or the heel is pointing straight up. We're just finding a nice crescent lunge. Long, deep inhale. See if you can squeeze those hips forward, let your shoulders relax, and then we're going to move from here to goddess. So you're going to open to goddess, and then we're going to close back. Same, right leg's going to be in front, in to your lunge. Squeezing, so just getting that rotation back into your lunge a couple of times. Hold there. Arms are going to come out in front of you. So you have options. You can just give yourself a hug with your right arm first and then your left arm. Maybe you can bring your left arm under the right arm so that your elbows are stacked. Maybe you can bring yourself into that eagle bind. So if you need to, right arm can come out, left arm can sweep under and then bind. That might be easier. Hold in here. We're going to take a deep, long breath. Reach the arms up, fingertips up towards the ceiling. As you exhale, sink down. Try to lean forward, see if you can tap. Inhale to lengthen back up. And exhale down. So if you don't have eagle, if you're just giving yourself a hug, you're not going to be able to tap. But you can do the same thing, just coming forward with the elbows. And up. We'll do one more. As you come up, lengthen everything out. And then as you exhale, turning over to the left side of your mat, step back to plank. This time we'll take a chaturanga. Knees can come down, elbows hugging in. Inhale up through the chest. And as you exhale, coming back, downward facing dog. Pedal the legs here, shift the hips a little. And we'll do it all on the other side. So when it feels good, left leg's gonna lift up, bend the knee, open the hips. Just starting here. Try to get the openness as much as you can. And then we'll bring that left knee in towards the chest, cross the ankle, cross the right thigh, and send your hips back. So you're in a down dog, figure four legs. Try to press that chest back. Notice if this side feels a little different than the other felt. And then looking forward, step your foot all the way up. We're going to find our high lunge. So reaching the arms up, squeeze everything in. Lengthening down the front of that right side. And we'll do the same thing as before. So you're starting here. You're going to open up into goddess, even if you don't turn all the way to the long edge. And then we'll close again. Opening up. And closing. Try to press into the front heel the whole time. So you're not putting the weight into your toes. We'll take one more. And then find your way to goddess, holding here. So just like before, you can give yourself a hug. Left arm's gonna come out in front, right arm will sweep under. You can hug back of the hands together, or maybe the full bind of the arms. And we'll lengthen up. Reach as high as you can with those fingertips. As you exhale, come on down, tapping. Inhaling up, exhaling down. One more time here, lifting up, reach the arms, lengthen up as tall as you can, turn back to the right, step to a plank, on your knees if you want to, find your way through, chaturanga, upward facing dog, and then come back to child's pose for a moment, maybe need a sip of water. Oh. Melting me. So, whenever you're ready for it, we're going to come back to the back of our mat. You're on your knees. We're going to tuck our toes under, squeeze the hips, and then just like we did on all fours, we're going to see if we can tap the knees out or the toes out to the side and back in. So if it's too much to do both, you can alternate, doing one at a time. Just try to internally rotate through that hip. And then the next time you have your toes out a little, hold them there, squeeze those hips forward, just hang out here for a moment. Might not feel like a lot. You can even kind of wiggle the hips side to side. And then as you exhale, hands back down, tuck your toes, come into downward facing dog. We're going to cross the left foot in front of the right foot. Holding here. Just changing up the stretch in your down dog. See if you can tilt the tailbone up towards the ceiling. And then take the feet back and cross the right foot in front of the left foot. Tilting this tailbone up. Notice if this side feels a little different. And back to center. Walk your hands back towards your feet. Find a forward fold at the back of your mat. Take a moment to grab your hands back behind you, clasping. See if you can reach the arms away. Rock around a little. See how it feels. And then as you exhale, release, roll yourself all the way up, lengthening nice and tall, and then exhale the hands down. So we're just going to step the, we're going to step the left foot forward so that it's in the center, not in the center of the mat, but like in the center of the back of your mat. So you're just stepping it forward a little bit. We're going to take the right leg, you're going to wrap it around and squat a little bit. Okay, so you're coming towards eagle, but don't get too crazy. You don't have to wrap it all the way around because we're going to move. Because we're going to step right foot down and then change over to the other side. Finding that little bit of squat, squeezing in the glutes. Step that foot in front of the other. Switching legs all the way up the mat. Kind of suck those inner thighs towards each other. Get to the top of your mat, you're going to step back with the left leg, finding your way into goddess. Press into the knees, let your shoulders drop in a couple of times. And then when you're ready, lengthen up long. We're going to heel toe the feet towards each other, coming to standing, and then we're going to find our way into eagle a couple of times. So we're going to start with my fave, a couple of like curtsy lunges, and then we'll move into the eagle. So just getting ourselves nice and strong and ready for it. So we're going to take a deep inhale, bring the left knee out, lengthen those arms back behind you. As you exhale, left leg is going to come behind the right, find a nice curtsy. You'll inhale up, opening through the chest, exhale, coming in front. So you can wrap or you can tap. Inhale, opening, exhale, tapping down in that curtsy lunge. Get your glute involved. Open here and then close. Couple more times. Then next time you have your leg coming in the front, we'll find our eagle with the legs. So you're trying to wrap your top leg around the bottom. Your toe can come to the ground. If you bend the knees a little bit more and send your inner thighs inward, better chance of coming all the way into it. Right arm's going to come out in front. We'll sweep the left arm under. You can hug or wrap. Maybe you can lengthen. Maybe you can sink. Ooh, maybe I can't. Ooh. Maybe you can sink down and hook your elbows on the knee. There we go. Focus on getting the glute on your right leg engaged. So you're pressing into the heel, really squeezing. Couple more breaths here. Hopefully feeling a little burn. And then go ahead and reach all the way up. Unwind. Shake out the legs. Shake through the hips. Whew. And then we'll do the other side. So starting out, get yourself comfortable. Get that left leg strong. Booty squeezing. When it feels good, right knee is going to come out to the side. We're going to open up. And then as you exhale, give yourself a hug. Tap behind. Squeeze in the butt. Got the heel pressing into the ground. We'll open again. And then close in front. Squeezing out. Hugging yourself because you love yourself. Open out. Couple more times. Really try to get that squat in. We'll take it one last time towards the back. When you come forward this time, wrapping it around, seeing if you can get the legs to rotate in towards each other, left arm in front, right arm will sweep under. You can hug, you can clasp for the bind, maybe you can sink forward. Squeeze that glute really hard. You should feel it kind of shaking a little, quivering. And then when you're ready, unwind, shake it out. Shift the hips side to side. Take the feet a little bit wide. You might find you need to adjust as we come down. We're going to find Malasana, so kind of counter-stretching that internal rotation with an external rotation, just sinking down. Use your hands if you need to. Ah. Getting nice and comfortable. See if you can press your thighs in towards your elbow, your elbows into your thighs. Squeeze the booty so you're not just relaxed here. You're active through that lower body. Sweating up a storm. When it feels good, hands down, send the hips back up. See if it feels good to clasp your hands behind you, finding a fold here. Maybe moving side to side. And then as you exhale, release your arms. You're going to turn yourself back to the front of your mat. Come on down to your knees. Take a couple rounds of cat and cow. Together. Take your feet wide, but the tops of your feet are on the ground. We're going to see if we can sit back towards hero. So you want your hips to come down. You might need to move your calves out of the way. Heels are on the outside of your hips and the tops of your feet on the ground. So if your side of your foot is on the ground and the top of your foot's facing outward, try to tuck it under. You can use your hands to get yourself more comfortable here. If you have a block, you can sit on it. Just relaxing here. Seeing how it feels through the knees, the tops of the quads. If it's uncomfortable anywhere, you can come forward and just kind of sit on the heels instead of having them out to the sides. And then when you're ready for it, we're going to shift forward again. Bring your knees back to center, take a round of cat and cow. Come back through center. Before we come back to seated, I'm gonna move my shirt so you can see what's happening in my hips. Don't mind the belly. When it feels good, so you're gonna press into your hands, keep your upper body nice and still. We're gonna focus just on the hips. So we're not doing cat and cow, so you're not bringing your chest. You're just gonna tilt your hips up and down. So just as far as you can, it's just a little subtle movement. Really focus on that low belly if you can. Moving up and down, slow motion twerking. Just kind of bringing some release into those hip joints. And some strength into your low belly. Really drawing it up towards your ribs. One more time here. And then shake it out. I'll cover up my belly again. When it feels good, you're going to take left leg. You're going to cross it behind the right leg. Take the feet out to the sides as far as you can. And we're going to try to walk the hands back and sit down between the heels. If you get near here and you're like, what the F, Kayla? You can extend your left leg long You have the knee drop down for cow face. So get comfortable as you need to. Notice if one side feels a little bit different than the other or a little bit tighter than the other, and we're going to bring the left arm back behind the head. Grab hold of your elbow, open up through the chest. If it feels good, you can hold on to your shirt and bring your opposite arm behind you, holding your shirt, or maybe you can clasp. So I'll just turn a little so you can see what I mean. You can have your hand here holding and holding your shirt, or maybe you can clasp your hands. Trying to get nice and long through the spine. Don't let your chin get smashed into your chest. And if you like, you can kind of lean forward, try to bring your middle of your chest towards the front of your mat. Notice how that changes the stretch in your hip and your booty. Take some long, slow breaths here. Maybe bring your mind back to your intention or your mantra. Try to get both hips so they're pointing down towards the ground. So if you need to, stick a block underneath that right booty. And then you can lengthen out and sink down. If you want this to be a little bit more intense while you're on the ground, if it feels good, you can tuck in that left leg and grab for the foot with the right hand. Finding a twist and a quad stretch and a hip stretch. All in one. Take two more breaths here. And then we'll release that foot. Walk your hands back, press into them. We're just gonna slide that right leg back, shift around a little here, moving hips side to side. Notice how they feel different. And then this time we're going to take the right knee, cross it behind the left knee, bring the feet as far out as you can, and we'll walk the hands back to sit. So just like before, your right leg can come straight out. Just make sure your left leg, the knee, is coming towards the right knee. And you're on the side of the foot. Seeing if the side feels different. It feels awful for me. This right leg is feeling real tight. When you're ready, right arm will come up. You can take it behind your head and hold on to the elbow for that tricep stretch. You can hold on to your shirt and grab the shirt with your opposite hand. Or you can take yourself into that full bind with the hands if you have the flexibility in the shoulders. And then just like before, if it feels good, maybe leaning forward a little bit, putting the weight towards the legs. Try not to let your chin get smashed down by your arms, keeping your chest nice and long. Breathe in here. Front of your mat, right leg's gonna slide back, finding that pigeon pose, even out through your hips, get nice and comfortable down on the forearms if you can, and just like before, if it feels good, you can tuck in that right foot, grabbing for it with your left hand, bringing yourself into a twist, hip stretch. Getting all comfortable here. Two more breaths. And then go ahead and release. We're going to come to the outside of the left hip. Sweep both legs around you. Soles of the feet onto the ground. Hands back behind you. You can turn your fingertips towards your hips if it feels good. And we're just going to windscreen wipe with the knees side to side. If it feels good, you can open your chest towards the ceiling while you're over there stretching down the arms. Center. Feet on the ground, slide yourself towards the top of your mat and roll on down to the back. Rock around when you get here. Your underarms. You can keep holding here on your knees if you like. You can grab hold of your ankles or your feet and you can take happy baby. Just try to keep your whole spine on the ground so you have your low back pressing down. And then you can lift those heels up high, maybe rock. Releasing the feet, arms out to the side. Just let your knees drop over to the left. Holding here, finding your twist. Try to get your right shoulder down. Take some long, deep breaths in and out. Even out your hips, allow them to drop over to the other side. Center. Feet flat on the ground. We're going to do a little bit of glute activation before we come into our Shavasana. So feet flat on the ground. Take a moment. Hands are going to come onto your thighs. Press the hands into the legs. See if you can kind of walk your shoulders away from your hips. Feeling a little bit of traction in the low ceiling, keeping everything where they are. So you're just squeezing your butt. Strong, strong, strong. Noticing if maybe one feels a little bit easier to squeeze than the other. When you're ready, you're going to release just the right side. Keep squeezing that left side. Keep squeezing the left side. See if you can bring the right side just like 50% of a squeeze. And then all the way up to 100% and release the left one. Holding just the right side. Squeezing it as hard as you can. We're going to try to bring the left one in when you're ready, halfway. Just squeezing it 50%. And then we'll move up to 100. Really firm through both glutes. When you're ready, we're going to go halfway down. So 50% on both sides. Just a light squeeze. And then squeeze hard, 100%. If you want to, you can keep squeezing here, pressing into the heels, pull your belly in, start to lift the hips up, just coming into a glute bridge, not very high. Tucking the tailbone towards the backs of the knees. One more like that. Deeply inhale. Exhale out through the mouth. And then just let your breath relax, settling in for your Shavasana. Take some long, smooth inhales and exhales. Try to focus on relaxing in the body. Maybe repeating your mantra or your intention in your mind. Start to lengthen out long through the legs and the arms, taking a deep inhale in. As you exhale, bend one knee at a time, gently roll off onto one side. Relaxing here for a moment. crossing at the ankles. We're going to do a little breathing exercise. So last week we did just right nostril breath. We're going to do the same thing, except this time you're going to breathe in through the right nostril, and we're going to see if we can hold it for four counts. So you can breathe in for four, hold for four, and out for four through the left nostril if you want, or you can just breathe in and out. If it's comfortable though, four in through the right, hold for four, and four out through the left. So you can use your like deer fingers if you want, or you can just hold with your first finger and thumb. Whenever you're ready, just deeply inhaling in, holding, and then out through the opposite nostril. Only holding on the inhale. One more round like this. And then on your next inhale, just inhale in through both nostrils. Exhale out through the mouth. Inhale, reaching both arms up. Lengthen as long and tall as you can. Exhale the hands to the heart center. Take a moment to give gratitude to your body. May the light within me reach out and touch the light within all of you. Thank you so much for joining me. So last week I said if you wanted to journal to write down the qualities that you admire in someone, and then this week I want you to add to that by writing down I am and then whatever the qualities that you wrote. So I am strong. I am the most beautiful person in the world. I am whatever. So I want you to write it about yourself, and I will see you.